I'm not even sworn in yet, and I'm cleaning up the mess around here. All right, who's this? About this right here?
If it'll stay. Wait, here we go.
How's it? Teamwork.
Will that work?
I think so. Well, good morning. Thank you for joining us today in announcing a new chapter in public safety for the city of Chicago. Throughout my campaign for mayor and many conversations I've had with Chicagoans, public safety was and remains a top priority. And during such a crucial time, I've been committed to finding someone to lead the Chicago Police Department who is caring, collaborative, compassionate, competent in their approach to supporting the people of Chicago. It was also important to find someone who understands the dynamics of our communities, someone respected by both the rank and file officers and the residents that they serve. You all know I live in Austin. It's a beautiful community. It's where my wife and I are raising our three children. But it is one of the most violent communities in Chicago. So I am doubly invested in the safety of our streets. You know, I want that for my family. I do. But just as I want that for my family, I want safety for every single family in the city of Chicago. So it is my honor to stand before you today in announcing my plans to appoint Chief Fred Waller as our interim superintendent of the Chicago Police Department, and this will be effective May 15th. Chief Waller has dedicated his career to serving the people of the city of Chicago at virtually every level of the department, from patrol officer to third in command. He has the experience and integrity to lead the Chicago Police Department during this pivotal time. In the course of our conversations, it was apparent to me that we share the same vision for a safer and a stronger Chicago, and that there was much potential in reimagining public safety while upholding the traditional values of serving families and, of course, our communities. Chief Waller is a respected veteran of the Chicago Police Department with the ability to embrace models of community-led policing and the calls for accountability that will help restore and rebuild relationships between officers and those they are entrusted to protect. He shares my commitment to constitutional policing. He is deeply committed to accountability, collaboration, and excellence, which will set the tone for the entire department during this crucial interim period. So again, it is my honor to welcome Chief Waller back to the department, and I look forward to working closely with him to execute a public safety plan to keep the people of Chicago safe while also making critical investments that address the root causes of crime and conditions that have plagued our streets for generations. Again, it is my deep honor to bring back our dear friend and brother, Chief Waller.
Thank you, Mayor-elect Johnson, and thank you everyone for joining us this morning. I'm honored to be elected and selected, I should say, as the interim superintendent for the department that I humbly served for 34 years. This is a crucial moment for our city. If there's one thing that could bring me out of retirement, it was this opportunity to leave and return to the place that I've given so much of my life to. I understand firsthand the sacrifices that officers make every day to keep our city safe. And I am committed to providing the resources, the direction, and the training they need to fulfill the commitment to the people of our city. We must protect the people of Chicago. We must also be mindful of the relationships between the department and the communities we serve. We must rebuild trust, and we must rebuild morale in the department. We can and will do both. I'm not going to front. I'm old school, as you all know. But I'm old school with integrity, professionalism, and respect. I worked on both the south side. I worked all over the city. In every corner of the city, I've had an opportunity to work. And with that being said, I've seen the brutality on the Chicago streets. But I've also seen the beauty in the city and in our neighborhoods and in the people. And I know that we can accomplish in our department with collaboration, compassion, and dedication to work out in our communities. I recognize the great potential there is in upholding the core values of the Chicago Police Department. Along with the vision of Mayor-elect Johnson, I am ready to lead our city in this crucial moment with the understanding that this is essential, and we will engage with the most impacted by violence, crime, to identify concerns and needs of our city. Thank you.
Thank you again, Chief Waller. We're looking forward to building a better, stronger, safer Chicago, and we're going to do it together. Take a couple of questions.
Mayor Johnson, I have a question, please. Are you looking for Chief Waller to take the job?
Chief Waller has expressed that his main responsibility is to be a part of the transition as we move into finding a permanent person.
Mayor-elect Johnson, you talked about experience and integrity. Fred Waller worked for many years alongside and as a commanding district commander of Ronald Watts. After Ronald Watts was arrested with another member of his crew, Fred Waller nominated for promotion to his promotion to sergeant, Watts' right-hand man, a guy who was known as his enforcer, his bodyguard. It was 10 months after the arrest. The same guy took more than a decade.
You okay?
I've got a little time.
That's okay.
It took more
Take
than
your
a
time.
Decade for city officials to get this officer off the force. He resigned last year upon the release of a city report calling for his dismissal, a report that focused on that crew's extortion. Fred Waller was very close to this. People who worked on that in that unit, around that unit, said there's no way he didn't know about this. You talk about it, experience, integrity, and you've talked about changing the department. What's going on here?
When you say what's going on here, what are you referring to?
Is he the change agent that you promised in your campaign?
Fred Waller is someone that I have confidence in to make sure that we build a better, stronger, safer Chicago.
Mr. Waller, are you
worried about the connection? Are you saying that did you look into it?
We've had extensive conversations with Chief Waller, and
did he explain why he nominated this officer for promotion to sergeant, connected to one of the worst police scandals in Chicago police history?
I'm confident that Chief Fred Waller is the best person to serve as the interim superintendent to move our transition forward. Alice?
Alice, go ahead, please.
Okay, are you applying for the permanent position, yes or no?
No, I don't plan on.
Come on, sit right.
Sorry. I don't plan on applying for the permanent position, no.
Memorial Weekend is approaching. Historically, it's one of the most violent weekends in Chicago. Does the police have to do something different this year?
Well, it's a comprehensive approach. Look, as I said, and I've stated repeatedly, that violence that we talk about that happens historically is something that is regular in neighborhoods that have been disinvested in. And so our approach is going to be smart. And we are having ongoing conversations about how to best layer a response, not just for Memorial Day weekend, but throughout the entire summer.
Yes, ma'am.
I got you. Morale in the police department. When I talk to officers on the street, a lot of times they're afraid to talk. But one thing I hear from every single one of them is how low morale is at CPD. How do you bring that up?
The main thing is support. We, in the police department, they didn't feel the support from previous administrations, and I don't want to go back into that, but just there wasn't the support that the officers felt. There were some things that happened during the civil unrest, during the pandemic, in which the officers were the only people, along with the fire department, who had to still go out on the street. And I watched, during that time when I was there, over 1,000 officers become ill, but they could not stop. And when the civil unrest came, you still have to support those officers and show them that if you make a mistake, you're not gonna be thrown out with the trash, and they have to feel that support. And I think that with this administration, they will.
Mr. Waller, you were suspended for 28 days yes. for likening the redeployment of officers to rape or sexual assault. What did you learn from that suspension, and what would you say to female officers who don't think that you are the appropriate choice to lead the department, given that remark?
There were females in the room, and I'll be 100% transparent. It was the wrong choice of words. It was an attempt to emphasize how much resources were being taken from patrol, and it was just inappropriate the way I phrased it. It was taken out of context. There were females in the room, and at that time
those
it was a little.
Those females filed the complaint against you.
Well,
eight
female did, and as far as the suspension, I gave up my complete vacation to supplement that time that I would have been suspended. I never stopped working. I was given that in February, actually, and I continued to work all the way until August. I never missed one day for that suspension. I gave up my vacation to supplement that.
So you're saying you were not actually punished for likening the redeployment of officers to rape?
Well, if you say not having a vacation is being punished, then maybe I wasn't punished, but I was given the suspension. And I, in lieu of not coming to work, because we had many, many things to still accomplish, I gave up my vacation. That was the 2 years that I gave up my vacation because we were trying to come under 500 murders at that time, and there were some things going on. So that was 2 years I didn't have a vacation.
Chief Waller, what will your plan be to keep Chicago from experiencing another weekend like we did in mid-April, where these mobs of young kids came downtown and just created chaos? And
We've done some collaborative things in the past with some street intervention teams, and I see that some of the pastors and dads are getting involved, and it has to be a collaborative effort. We have to use some innovative ways to look at it, and I've had a chance to sit back on the sideline and look at maybe some of the mistakes that we might have made in the past. We also have to include CPS because many of these teens attend CPS schools, so we have to include them also.
Chief Waller, do you think the police department should end its contract with ShotSpotter?
I believe that everything probably needs to be reviewed and looked at. My mission, along with Mayor-elect Johnson, is public safety, keeping the people in the city of Chicago safe. So I think everything probably needs to be reviewed and looked at to make sure that we're using the best resources.
How soon will you promote 200 detectives or implement other parts of the Mayor-elect's public safety plan?
You know, again, this is going to be a collaborative approach, and, you know, this is interim. Having the confidence of Chief Waller and the confidence of the rank and file that we will actually have a plan that speaks to constitutional policing and to make sure that we're actually solving violent crimes in the city of Chicago. So my desire, of course, is to move with all expediency. And again, looking forward to having Chief Waller's expertise and as well as his command of what it takes to have, again, a smart approach towards policing.
Mayor-elect, can you repeat? Did you consider anybody who is currently in the department for this role? And what should people read into your decision to pull somebody out of retirement as opposed to giving that person a leg up for the permanent job?
It's a very good question. I appreciate that. I like the more thematic, holistic approach where it allows for, you know, like a real exchange of ideas. Appreciate that. So yes, you know, I talked to a number of individuals that are currently serving in law enforcement. You know, what stood out for me with Chief Waller was not only his consciousness around how do we make sure that the rank and file members of our police department have what they need, but also his consciousness around smart policing and engaging the community, something that we can do a lot better of implementing. The other dynamic about Fred Waller that is quite impressive, his entire family is dedicated to public safety in Chicago. That's darn literally his entire family. And so not only has he come through the ranks, his family has been on the front line working to protect our city. And look, it's rare to have someone of his caliber and his expertise who comes from the rank and file, who lives in this city, who's invested in this city, and has a very dynamic view of what it's going to take to ultimately keep the people of Chicago safe. And then the fact that he has committed himself to being part of this transition, so that as we go through the selection process, we have someone who can help set the right tone for what people, the people of Chicago, can expect moving forward. Thank
Last
you.
Last question, Mayor Lake Johnson, do you favor the use of the former South Shore High School to house immigrants sent here from Texas? And what will your administration do as soon as you take office to address the humanitarian crisis?
Thank you for that question. Everybody's really getting good at asking me questions. I feel like
it's literally our job.
No, I appreciate that, but it doesn't mean everybody does it right, though. So, and it's just refreshing to feel that. So, even though it is your job, I just want to acknowledge the fact that you all are doing a good job at it, is what I'm saying. I hope you are as complimentary to me in a couple of years as I am to you. The truth of the matter is that, you know, we have, governors at the border that have demonstrated that they are not willing to collaborate in a real way. And so that is still, of course, very disappointing. And one of the things to the second part of your question, I'm prepared to have conversations with everyone, and particularly those who may use this as a weapon against cities. You know, the fact that many of these asylum seekers, if not the vast majority of them, are in real difficult condition, emotionally and physically, being used as a political football is still unconscionable. So what I favor and what we will do day one is to make sure that there is a real effort to coordinate our resources, the federal, state, the county, and the city level. We are already in the process of developing that infrastructure for that type of coordination. And then, of course, back to the first part of your question about what I favor and what my preferences always will be is a real community process that allows for our response to not just meet the need, but that it includes all stakeholders in solving what ultimately is, you know, is a crisis that is, quite frankly, is engineered, right? And so I'm going to work with the people of Chicago. Of course, our alderpersons that represent areas, you know, where we can be supportive for asylum seekers. But then the last thing is, many communities have been denied for too long basic amenities and resources that can help strengthen those communities. And the stronger our communities are, the better positioned we will be to support those who are struggling. You know, right now, we have this weight in many of our communities that, you know, look, you all know where I started my career. And, you know, school closings are still very, very traumatic, right? The harm and the pain and the anguish that was caused, still is a hardship. And so I don't want to be responsible for any type of re-triggering of that trauma. And so we're going to work with sensitivity, and we're also going to work with intentionality. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Waller.
Chief Waller, congratulations.
Thanks, guys.